Hey guys, I'm back with my video, and today I'm here for a video. Boy, I ain't here for no point video. But today I'm gonna read USB to you again. I said I was probably gonna read USB to you, or maybe not, but let's just get straight to it again. So, you know, we knew he ran out the house. He ran out from the person that wasn't his owner and trying to find his owner. So, let's read it. Which made a shell against the wheel, shivering, he fell asleep in an aura of violence and gasoline. Gasoline on your lips. Yeah, how about that? Early the next morning, Wisby was awakened when the owner of the station came to work. "Beat it, mutt," said the man. He was not angry, but he did not want a dog getting in the way. Wisby obeyed. He was cold, damp, stiff, sperms, and hungry, which was all bad enough. He did not want to be unwelcome, too. So he trotted off down the hallway looking for a way to move his situation. He'd not gone far when his nose caught a faint smell that was strong enough to rise above him, the now fading violence. Coffee to Risby, that smell meant breakfast. Not the Risby drink coffee. In the Huggins household, coffee was always bubbling in the electric pot when Henry opened the refrigerator door to get out the dog for food for Risby. Thus, the smell of coffee had come to stand for breakfast to Risby, just as it did to people. Risby let his nose lead him to the source of coffee smell, a window that was a few inches and near of a small white house set back from the highway. Risby could hear someone moving around in the kitchen at home when Risby was outdoors and wanted to be fed, and he scratched at the door. That was what he did now. When the door was opened by an old lady, Risby lifted his ears and waggled his tail hopefully. My goodness, exclaimed the old lady, whose name is Wooly. A dog, shoo, go away. Her voice was not unkind. So Risby hopefully waggled his tail harder. That coffee smell must mean that the dog food was near. Shoo! Mrs. Foley started to shut the door in Risby's face. Shoo! She had shoo dogs out of her yard for so many years that it had become a habit with her. Then the eager, researching look on Risby's face must have caught her attention, because she is thirsty. She is thirsty. Risby moved a step closer. "I believe you're hungry," said the old lady. Risby sat down and held up her paw. This often pleased people. It pleased Miss Foley. "Why, Mr. Dog, how do you?" she inquired. "Woof," answered Risby. Who felt that situation uncomfortable? "Did someone dump you out the highway to get rid of you?" she asked, "because this often happens here at the edge of the city." "Woof," said Wisby. Agreeable. He was making every effort to be charming. Miss Farley relented. All right, you look like a nice dog. I'll give you something to eat. Don't go away. Wisby had no intention of leaving, especially when he heard the refrigerator door open. Miss Farley relented even further. Food. She returned to the door and pushed it open. You must be cold. Come on in. This is my day. To scrub the kitchen floor. Anyway, Wingly Risby entertained the kitchen, and the door was shut behind him. The end. So some lady took him. That's fine. That's not the end. Now this is the last page I'm going to read. Now let's see. Must Miss Folly what? Can I find a dog to eat? There was not much in the refrigerator. Miss Folly, whose husband was dead and his children were grown, lived alone. How would you like a scrambled egg? She looked at Wisby eager face. Two scrambled eggs. She poured a bowl of milk and set it on the floor. While Wisby laughed thirstily, she said about scrambling two eggs, which she set on the floor beside the empty milk bowl. Wisby sniffed and then licked casually. As soon as the eggs had cooled enough, he wolfed them down and looked hopefully for more. You are a hungry dog, said Miss Falling. And I briefly scrambled two more eggs, and you smell so nice, like violets. While she watched Risby eat, she could not help thinking that it was pleasant to prepare breakfast for someone once more, even if it was only a dog. Miss Folly was a very lonely person. Her eyesight was not as good as it used to be, and she could no longer crouch or read very much. She can read, but how I can read? That's what I learned. So, in the comments, tell me if this book is a fairy tale. I think this book is a fable. I think this book is a nonfiction or a fable. A fable is it's true but really fake. It's true, it can happen, but it's fake. So I hope you like this video. So yeah, I hope you like this video. Like, subscribe. See you next time. Bye.